So my dear friends, in our last class, we are familiar with what exactly do we mean by shares and dividend. A share is a share in the share capital of a company, whereas a dividend is a part of the profit which the company distributes among its shareholders. We also know how to find investments. Investments are number of shares multiplied by market price. Whereas dividend is also called as annual income, which means number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. So these are very, very important formulas. Almost all the questions that we are going to do, we are going to follow the same formula. We also know that shares can be issued at par. Shares can be issued at discount and it can be issued at premium. Whenever we compute premium or a discount, it will always be on the face value. The alternative name for face value would be nominal value. So my dear friends, get ready to solve the questions. Most important thing is to interpret the right language of the question. Here we go with the first question. Manish opens. So now one thing is very short. Now let us say Manish wants to buy 1000 shares of Reliance Industries. Now if Manish wants to buy 1000 shares of Reliance Industries, knowing the fact that each share is available for 28 rupees. So that means if market price of the share is rupees 28, Manish wants to buy 1000 shares. So what would be the quantum of investment of Manish? So the answer would be, investment would be number of shares into market price. Why, sir? How many shares is buying? 1000. What is the rate of one share? 28. So what is the cost of 1000 shares? Sir, 28 into 1000. That's 28,000. It's very easy to find out the investment. It's just how much a person would like to invest. So now we'll start with 3A exercise. First question of 3A exercise. I am reading you, which is as under. How much money will be required to buy 400 rupees 12.50 shares? So basically, how much? So how much is the investment? How many shares we are buying? So it is clearly mentioned how much money will be required to buy 400. So 400 is a number of shares. 400 rupees 12.5 shares. It means face value is rupees 12.50. Let us see if it is available at par, it is available at discount, or it is available at premium. Let us read that. How much money will be required to buy 400 rupees 12.50 shares at a premium of rupees 1? So how do you find the market price? So market price would be face value plus premium. What is the face value? So 12 rupee 50 paise. How much is the premium? Rupee 1. So what is the market price? 30.50. That means someone is interested in buying 400 shares. Question mein diya gaya hai rupees 12.50 share. When I say rupees 12.50 share, it means the face value of the share is rupees 12.50. It is available at a premium of rupee 1. So the issue price or the marked price would be, that is the market price would be, the price at which the shares are available in the market. That's a market price. It is available at a premium of rupees 1. So 12.50 plus 1, 13.50. How much investment? So investment would be number of shares multiplied by market price. Number of shares 400 multiplied by market price 13.50. So my dear friends, 2754 rupees 5400 is the total quantum of money that is required to buy 400 shares. This is exercise 3.1 or exercise 3A. from the book Selina Publication. So this is the first question. Here we go with second question. It says, how much money will be required to buy 250? Now this time, number of shares are 250. Because they are asking you how much money is required to buy 250. Rupees 15 shares at a discount of 1.50. Clearly mentioned rupees 15 shares. So face value is rupees 15. Since it is available at a discount, so the discount amount is 1 rupee 50 paise. That's what is mentioned in the question. How much money will be required to buy 250 rupees 15 shares at a discount of rupees 1.50? So my dear friends, my mark price would be 15, that is face value, minus 1.50, that is 13 rupee and 50 paise. How much will be investment amount? So it depends upon number of shares and market price. Number of shares 250, market price 13.50. How do you multiply? So 250 multiply by 27 upon 2. How do you do this? So we can simply multiply and say that 125 multiply by 27. 125 multiply by 27. 3375. So my dear friends, my total investment would be rupees 3375. I promised you this topic is going to be very, very simple. What we need to remember is every time they come out with the question, we should be smart enough to identify the number of shares, market price. And how do you find the market price? So market price would be face value plus premium or face value minus discount, depending upon whether the shares are issued at a premium or a discount. With this, let's move on to the next question. A person buys 120 shares at a nominal value of rupees 40 each. So a person buys 120 shares. Number of shares? 120 shares. At what price? Sir, at a nominal value. So I am buying shares at nominal value, which is also my market price. How much is that? So rupees 40. So what is the cost of 120 shares? So one share is for 40 rupees. So cost of 120 shares would be 120 into 40. That is rupees 4800. Absolutely right. Now this guy, what he does is, he bought the shares at 40 rupees, but when the price rose to 42 rupees 50 paise, he sold all his shares. I hope you remember, why do you invest in shares? So I invest in shares for two reasons. One is dividend and another is appreciation. This guy is investing for appreciation. He bought for 40 rupees and now when the price went up to 42 rupees and 50 paise, he would like to sell all his shares. So how much will be the sale proceeds? Sale proceeds. So what do you mean by sale proceeds? Sale proceeds means the amount which one gets by selling the shares. How many shares I am selling? So 120. At what rate I am selling? So 42 rupees and 50 paise. So basically I'll have to work out on this. 120 multiply by, can we write this as 425 upon 10? It will be more easier for us. Of course, sir. So when we cancel, now we just have to find out how much is this working out to. It will be 5100. Lovely. He bought the shares for 4800. He sold all the shares for 5100. So how much will be the profit? So profit would be, of course, sale proceeds. Of course, yes, sir. Sale proceeds minus my cost. My sale proceeds were 5100. My cost were 4800. So my profit would be rupees 3000. Sorry, 300. Just 300. 300. Now, my dear friends, in this story, a person bought 120 shares at a face value of 40. So the total cost of 120 shares, 120 into 44800. He sold all the shares when the price shot up from 40 to 42.50. I worked out that comes to 5100. Selling price 5100, cost price 4800. Difference between the sales minus cost 300, 300 is my profit. If I ask you beyond this, what is the percentage profit? So percent profit will be profit upon cost into 100. This formula has got nothing to do with shares and dividend. This formula we had been learning since ages. So it's a very simple formula. That would be 300. What is my cost? 4800 multiply by 100. 0000. So 300 upon 48. It can go by 6. So 6 8s up. And this can be 650s up. That will give me 25 upon 4, which is 6.25%. So my dear friends, it's such a simple question. We found out profits. After finding the profits, we also found out the profit percentage. How do we find profit percentage? So profit upon cost into 100. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 4. Here we go. Find the cost of 85 shares. Number of shares given to us. Of rupees 60 each. When quoted at 63.25. So basically, number of shares given in the question. Find the cost of 85 shares. 85 shares. So they are asking us, find the cost of 85 shares of rupees 50 each. Means face value is rupees 60 each. What about the market price? So they have already mentioned that find the cost of 85 shares of rupees 60 each when quoted. Quoted means when they are available in the market at 63 rupees and 25 paise. It means the market price of the shares is 63 rupees and 25 paise. So 63 rupees and 25 paise. How do we find? So investment equals to number of shares into market price. Number of shares, so 85. Market price, 63.25. Let us move on to the next question. Question number 5. Now when we refer question number 5, it is mentioned a man invests rupees 800. So your investment is given to us. A man invests rupees 800 in buying rupees 5 shares. So investment rupees 800 in buying rupees 5 share. Face value rupees 5. Let us see what other information is given to us. And when they are selling at a premium of rupees 1.15, he sells all the shares. Smarties. So he must have purchased when the price is 5. And he's selling. Selling price. Sir, when they were available at a premium of 1 rupee and 15 paise. Face value plus premium. In this case, this is what is my buying. This is what is my selling. A man is investing for appreciation. He bought the shares and he sold the shares. He bought when the price is 5. He sold when the price is 5 plus 1 rupee 15 paise premium. So 6 rupee and 15 paise is the selling price of the share. Now the question over here is, how many shares he bought by investing 800 rupees? So my dear friends, we all know investment equals to number of shares into market price. So basically, if you go to see investments, it's 800. Number of shares, sir, we don't know. Market price means he bought at 5 rupee only. This is a case of buying, not selling. Therefore, number of shares purchased would be 800 upon 5. that would give me 160 shares. So the number of shares purchased is 160. How many shares must have been sold by him? Sir, he sold 160 shares at 6 rupees and 15 paise. So basically, when we multiply 984 rupees is my sales. So what is the amount of profit which I have made? So profit equals to sales minus cost. My sales are 984. My cost is 800. So my profit is 184 rupees. Rupees 184. Wow, sir. Understood. What have they asked in the question? They are asking us, find his profit and profit percentage. I found out profit, percent profit. I'm sure I can now erase this. Percentage profit. Profit upon cost into 100. How much is the profit, sir? 184. How much is the cost, sir? 800 rupees. Into 100. So we are left with 184 upon 8. 184 upon 8, 2 and 3, 23%. So my dear friend, we can easily get the answer. I can show you an alternative way also of doing the same question. That means without doing so much of calculation, we could have done this way also. Cost price per share. How much? Sir, rupees 5. Selling price per share. How much? Sir, rupees 5 plus 1.15. This is the selling price per share. So how much is profit per share? Sir, profit per share is this only. 1.15 rupees. That is the premium that I enjoy. How many shares you have? Sir, my investment was rupees 800. So number of shares multiplied by my market price is 800. I don't know how many shares I have bought, but my cost was 5. So that means number of shares was 160. Knowing that I have 160 shares, my profit would be 160 multiplied by profit per share, 1 rupee 15 paise. When you multiply, you will get 184. If you want to find percentage profit is same as profit upon cost into 100, which will again give you 23% only. So it was a very simple question, my dear friends. Till now, we have not yet explored shares and dividend. What exactly shares and dividend is. But now onwards, after a few questions, couple of questions, you will see sincerely understand how we are applying the formulas that we have discussed before. Let's move on to question number 6. What it says? Find the annual income. See, when I'm talking about annual income, that means we are talking about dividend. So they are asking now, find the annual income derived from 125. From 125 means number of shares, 125 shares. It's very important that you interpret what is mentioned in the question. They are asking us, find the dividend. That means annual income derived from 125, comma. So this 125 is quantity, number of shares. So find the annual income derived from 125. Rupees 120 shares. Rupees 120 shares means face value is rupees 120. So find the annual income derived from 125. Rupees 120 shares paying 5% dividend. So rate of dividend 5%. What is the formula for dividend? So annual income means dividend. So dividend is number of shares multiplied by face value multiplied by rate upon 100. Number of shares, sir, 125. Face value, 120 रेट 5 अपॉन 100 जीरो कैंसिल जीरो 5 1s are 5 2s are 1s are 6s are 125 6s are 750 सो 750 दिस इज द एनुअल इनकम आई एम श्योर स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली वी हैव अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर वन मोर फॉर्मूला विद यू एट दिस स्टेज व्हाट हैपेंड इज सी अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग वी गेट डिविडेंड only on face value but when we invest in the company we don't get an opportunity to invest in the face value we might invest at the market price which is slightly higher than the face value I will give you one small illustration about Mr. Pankaj now what happened with Mr. Pankaj is this is a story of Mr. Pankaj so one must tell me how we should analyze Mr. Pankaj bought just one share all right so his investment is rupees 200 why sir he bought one share whose face value was 50 rupees market price was rupees 200 face value 50 ek share tha jiski face value 50 thi market price 200 rupees pankaj was very sure that this company is going to do really well So he bought the share at rupees 200. Company was paying a dividend. Rate of dividend of the company was 20%. So 20% was the rate of dividend. I want to know what is the amount of dividend Pankaj is going to receive. Sir, Pankaj will receive dividend equals to number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. Number of shares. Sir, Pankaj, as you said, his investment is 200. Market price is also 200. So he must invested only in one share. Number of shares, 1. Face value, sir, 50 rupees. Rate of dividend, 20 upon 100. 0000. Rupees 10. So this is the annual income of Mr. Pankaj.
Hey guys, we all know that Pankaj has invested into shares. And he has bought in just one share. What was his investment? Sir, rupees 200. What dividend did he receive? Sir, rupees 10. If I ask you how much is the return on his investment, then your answer would be, sir, return on investment.
Return on investment would be, So my return on investment is I got 10 rupee on an investment of rupees 200. If I express it in terms of percentage, it would be just 5%. Although the rate of dividend what the company is giving is 20%, but my return on investment is only 5%. Return on investment means how much dividend do I receive on my investment. So we have a very simple structured formula. If you follow that formula, trust me guys, it will be very, very simple and it will help you to find out so many things with ease and comfort. My formula would be nominal value. You can also call it face value. Face value. Now why to write face value also? We can simply write face value into rate of dividend equals to market price into ROI. ROI. Face value into rate of dividend equals to market price into ROI. Trust me guys, if you know this, there are four parameters which are there in this. If three parameters are given, we can find the fourth parameter. Want to check it out? Check it out. Suppose for this example only, I want to find out ROI. ROI. This is called return on investments, return on equity, return on capital, yield. Different names are assigned to it. It could be return on investment, return on my capital, return on my equity, yield, percentage return. It is all one and the same, my dear friends. There are only two percentages. There are only two percentages in the whole chapter. One is rate of dividend and second is return on investment. So if RD is given, this will be asked. If this is given, that will be asked. In short, if you look at this framing, face value, sir 50. Rate of dividend, sir 20. Market price, sir market price 200. Find ROI. So ROI would be 0 cancel 0, 0 cancel 0, 2 cancels 2. So sir, ROI would be 5%. There is no need for us for doing all these things. Directly you can obtain the answer. So in the list of formulas that we have done, you can also add the third formula which has been introduced to you right now. The first being investment, number of shares into market price. The second being dividend. Dividend equals to number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. The third being face value multiplied by rate of dividend equals to market price multiplied by ROI. In case if you are inclined to find out percentage profit, percent profit equals to profit upon cost into 100. At times, people may sometimes even ask me, ke, sir, what is the formula for sale proceeds? Sale proceeds means what money you get from sale of all your shares. So, number of shares multiplied by selling price. So, what is the difference between sale proceeds and investment? While investment, I purchase the shares. In case of sale proceeds, I sell the shares. So this is in a way is my cost. This is in a way is my sales. Remember, while buying I use market price as my cost. While selling I name it as selling price because I am selling it. These are all the formulas that one need to know for the purpose of shares and dividend. Also, we even know that issue price is nothing but face value plus premium, and it could be face value minus discount. My dear friends, discount or premium would always be computed and calculated on face value. So in case if you are familiar with the formulas which has been listed right next to you here, then these are the formulas that we are going to use for the purpose of solving all the questions of shares and dividend. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 7. Here we go. Now the question number 7 is read as under. A man invests 3072. So what is the amount of investment? So investment is 3072. So investment is 3072 in a company paying 5% per annum. Company is paying 5% per annum. Matlab rate of dividend is 5% per annum. A person invested 3075 in a company paying, why I write RD? RD is rate of dividend. Just for my understanding that it is rate of dividend. How much? 5%. When it's rupees 10 share. It's rupees 10 share. So face value of the share is rupees 10. So a man invests 3072 in a company paying 5% per annum when it's rupees 10 share can be bought for rupees 16. So in the market, the shares are available at rupees 16. So this is the information given to us. First thing, can you find number of shares? Yes, sir. Investment equals to number of shares multiplied by market price. 3072 equals to number of shares, so we don't know. Market price, so 16. So we can easily find out. Therefore, number of shares equals to 3072 upon 16. So what we get is number of shares. When we do this, we get 192 shares. Alright, my dear friends, it's a very simple question. Investment is given to us. Number of shares we have to find. Market price is given to us. So when we do this calculation, we get 192 shares. What is asked in the question? They are asking us, find the annual income. Now the question is, sir, since they are asking you annual income, why did you find the number of shares? My answer is annual income means dividend. Dividend depends upon three things: number of shares, face value, and rate of dividend. I was having face value, I was having rate of dividend, but I was not having number of shares. So I found out number of shares. Now I'll find out the first part, which is annual income. Now annual income is also called as dividend. So let us find out dividend. Dividend is number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. How many shares? 192. What is the face value of the shares? 10 rupee. Rate of dividend 5%. Zero cancels. 0, 5 ones are, 5 twos are, 9, 1, 6. So my dear friends, the dividend received would be rupees 96. It was genuinely a very simple question. Let us move on to question number 9. Question number 9. Here we go. Question number 8 is very similar question, can be done, very simple one. Question number 9. A man bought 50 shares of a company. So, number of shares, 50 shares. So, a man bought 50 shares of a company paying 12% dividend. So, rate of dividend is 12%. If you note down all the information, that means the data, then you only simply need to analyze the data properly. Make sure that you write your data appropriately. Because once, if you write your data appropriately, then you simply have to use the following formulas, depending upon what is your requirement. But if you will not patiently write down the data, that means you are not understanding the question. First thing is, use your IQ to actually interpret what exactly is given to you in the data. If you make mistake in interpretation, number of shares are given, but if you're writing it that as face value, you probably may go wrong. You have to be very cautious with that. Once you write your data appropriately, I am sure, then you will not make any mistake. So a man bought rupees 50 shares. See what has happened? What did I write? N equals to 50 shares. Now this is wrong information. This is how people get trapped. This is exactly the nature of mistake that happens. This is exactly the kind of illustration that I would like to give you. It is mentioned that a man bought rupees 50 shares. It is not given that a man bought 50 shares. It is given that a man bought rupees 50 shares. It means a man is buying a share whose face value is 50. So this is not the number of shares bought. This is the face value of the shares. I hope you will not make such mistake and interpret the question. Once your interpretation goes wrong, no one can save you. So kindly concentrate, read the question carefully, spend some time in reading the question, and only after that you start processing the question. Again, I am reading. A man buys rupees 50 share of a company paying 12% dividend at a premium of rupees 10. Face value is available, so market price would be face value plus premium. Since face value is 50, premium is 10, so market price would be 60. Face value is given, market price is given, rate of dividend is given. What is asked? They are asking us, first part, find the market price of 320 shares. So number of shares 320, so market price of 320 shares. Iska matlab, if I go to market to buy 320 shares, how much will be the cost? Sir, you are buying 320 shares. Each share will cost you 60 rupees. 32, 192, 00. Sir, market price of 320 shares would be 19,200 rupees. Absolutely fine. That was the first part of it. Second part, annual income. As you guys know, annual income. What do you mean by annual income? So annual income is nothing but same as dividend. Dividend and annual income one and the same. So what is the formula for dividend? So dividend equals to number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. Number of shares 320. Face value. What is the face value of the shares? 50 rupees. Rate. What is the rate of dividend? 12%. 0000. 32 multiply by 60. 1920. So my dear friends, annual income would be 1920. It was a very simple question, my dear friends. I mean, like, we can easily do it provided you write all your data properly. The last one, his profit person. See, he is not selling the shares. So when they are asking you a profit person, I hope you remember I told you. Whether they called you return on investment, return on capital, return on equity, profit percentage, they are asking only one thing, ROI. ROI means return on investment. So they are asking you profit percentage, that means they are asking you ROI. We only have one formula for ROI. Face value multiply by rate of dividend equals to market price multiply by ROI. Instead of writing ROI, we will write profit percentage. Does not make any difference. It is ROI which is profit percentage. What is the face value of the shares? The face value of the share is 50. Rate of dividend 12%. Market price 60. And ROI, so sorry, we don't know. 12 ones are, 12 fives are. Therefore, ROI equals to ones and tens are, it gives me 10%. So, my dear friends, if you notice this, ROI is nothing but profit percentage. We can easily find out by applying a formula, which we are using it so frequently and will be using it in future as well. Face value multiply by rate of dividend is equal to market price multiply by ROI. They had asked us the same thing. Let us do one more time. The same in case if this has got complicated over here. So we would do one more time. They are asking you find the percentage profit. So percentage profit is nothing but ROI. Face value multiply by rate of dividend equals to market price multiply by ROI. Face value. How much is the face value? So 50. Rate of dividend 12%. Market price. So market price is here 60 rupees. ROI. There is no need for us to write upon 100 because both the places will be writing upon 100. 100 will get cancelled. So it will remain as it is. 0 cancels 0. 6 ones are, 6 twos are, 5 twos are, 10 equals to ROI. ROI is return on investment. That means, sir, profit percentage would be 10%. This was the third part. First part, market price of the share. Second part, dividend. Third part, percent profit that I have earned. So guys, I'm sure up to now, you had been successfully getting almost all the questions that we have done so far. Let's move on to the next question. To question number 10, which says, a man buys rupees 75 shares. So a man buys rupees 75 share. So it is, face value is rupees 75. A man buys rupees 75 shares at a discount of rupees 50. Since discount is rupees 50, so what must be the market price of the share? So market price would be face value minus discount. Face value is how much? 75. Discount is 50. So market price would be 60. So it's given to us that a man buys rupees 75 shares, face value 75,
at a discount of rupees 50 of a company paying 20% dividend. Rate of dividend 20%. So we have copied all the necessary information. What is asked? Find the market price of 120 share. It is exactly the same type of question what we have done previously. Market price of 120 shares would be, how many shares we are buying? 120. What is the market price of one share? 60. 12, 6 are 72, 00. So market price of 120 shares is 7,200. Very pretty simple. Find his annual income. That's nothing but dividend. So dividend equals to, what is it? Sir, number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. Number of shares. How many shares are we buying? So we had purchased 120 shares. What is the face value of the shares? Sir, the face value of the share is 75 rupees. 75. Multiply by rate. Sir, 20%. 20 upon 100. 0, 0, 0, 0. So guys, we have 12. Multiply by 150. That will give you rupees 1800. So they asked us first question, what is the market price of 120 shares? Second question, what is the total annual income, that is dividend? The third part is profit percent. Profit percent is nothing but again ROI. That means face value multiply by rate of dividend, market price multiply by return on investment. What is the face value of the share? Sir, 75. Rate of dividend, 20. Market price, 60. Into ROI. 0 cancels 0. 1s are, 3s are. ROI equals to 75 upon 3. That is 25%. So, my dear friends, ROI is nothing but percentage of profit, which is 25%. Oh wow, it was such an amazing and a simple question. I hope everything else is going smooth. The only thing or a key to unlock this question is, please copy the questions correctly and interpret the data correctly. If you interpret the data correctly, chances that you are making mistake would be very less. Chances that you get the answer at the first shot would be quite high, and that is going to boost your confidence. That is going to help you have a confidence with respect to this topic. Let us move on to the next question. Question number 12. I'm doing alternate questions because they are more or less the same. Now, what does it say? The company pays a dividend of 15% on its 10 rupee shares. A company is paying a dividend. So, rate of dividend 15%. All it's mentioned clearly, a company pays a dividend of 15% on its 10 rupee share. 10 rupee share means face value is rupees 10. Alright. From which it deducts income tax at the rate of 22%. So, this question has got tax component. They say that 22% is a tax component. I will come to that. Let me read the question first. Find the annual income of a man who owns 1000 shares of this company. So how many shares does a man has? So 1000 shares. First thing is, let us find out annual income of a man. So his annual income would be number of shares into face value into rate upon 100. Because annual income is nothing but dividend. So how much? Sir, 1000 shares. What about the face value of the shares? Sir, 10. What about the rate? Sir, rate of dividend 15%. 0000. Sir, my income would be 1500. That's good, yeah. You have got an amazing income of 1500. But you know what? tax department says that a company who is paying a dividend must deduct 22% as a tax. So whenever a company will pay you, company will deduct 22% from your total income. Now your total income seems to be 1500. So tax, which tax? Income tax is how much? 22%. 22% of what? 22% of your income. 0000. We all know that we have to pay tax on our income. It is mentioned that a company is going to deduct a tax of 22%. Have a reading. A company pays a dividend of 15% on its 10 rupee share, from which it deducts income tax of 22%. So though a man will earn 1500, but a company will deduct the income tax of 330. So 330 would be deducted as a tax. What is asked? Find the annual income of a man. So basically we have to find out his annual income after paying the tax. Annual income of a man, that is after tax, means after paying tax. He was earning 1500, tax is 330, so undoubtedly 400, 1170. 1170 would be his annual earning. We did question number 10, question number 12. Now I'll move on to question number 14. Every alternate questions after question number 10. Until 10, we have done almost all the questions. So this seems to be the last question of this exercise. The rest, all the questions in between which I have left, that is question number 11, 13, 15, I expect you guys to do it. It's a very, very simple one. And I'm so sure you will get it in the first shot, provided you give your effort in interpreting what exactly is given to you in the question. Reading the data closely is very, very important. It's key to your success. So here we go with question number 14. A man invests 1680. So investment is given to us, question number 14. A man invests 1680. Investment rupees 1680. In buying shares of a nominal value, that is face value, of rupees 24. So face value is rupees 24. Let us see what else is given. A man invests 1680 in buying shares of a company with having a nominal value of 24 rupees and selling at 12% premium. So these shares are available in the market at what price? So face value plus 12% premium. It is mentioned in the question. Okay, they are available at 12% premium. So can we find out? Yes, sir. 24 plus 12% of 24. 24 plus 12 into 24, 288 upon 100. 24 plus 2.88. That is 26.88. So this is the market price of the share. It is mentioned that a man is investing 1680. Face value is 24. Shares are available at 12% premium. As we have always discussed, that premium or discount should be calculated on the face value. We computed it on the face value. We got to know the market price of the share. Market price of the share is 26.88. What is the question? Find the number of the shares he buys. As we know, investment equals to number of shares into market price. 1680 equals to number of shares into market price. So how do you go about? So number of shares would be 1680 upon 26.88. Very unique answer you are going to get. Very unique answer. You will remember this for your lifetime. Very unique answer. Your answer is 62.5 shares. Generally, the minimum denomination in which you can buy the share is 1. Minimum you can buy 1 share. Maximum you can buy any number of shares. But buying 62.5 shares seems to be absurd. But there is no mistake from our end, my dear friends. The mistake is in its framing. The framing of the question with respect to its number may be wrong. Nevertheless, the correct answer is 62.5 as per the question. But practically speaking, we can't buy 62.5 shares. We can buy either 62 shares or 63 shares, but not 62.5 shares. Alright, my dear friends, after that, find the dividend he receives annually. We all know dividend equals to number of shares multiplied by face value multiplied by rate upon 100. How many shares? Sir, 62.5 shares. What is the face value? Sir, 24. What about the rate? Rate of dividend given to us? Let us see. It is mentioned that the dividend on the shares is 15% per annum. Rate of dividend is 15% per annum. So it would be 15 upon 100. So my dear friends, when we work out this, what exactly are we going to get? 22,500 upon 100. That will be rupees 225. So the amount of dividend that the person will receive on this shares would be rupees 225. With this, we have finished with our first exercise, which was really very simple, easy, and enhancing our knowledge with respect to the new concepts of shares and dividend. I'm sure you guys are going to enjoy this, working on shares and dividend intrinsically, for a simple reason that it will set a new horizon to take interest in the new subject related to shares and dividend. Thank you so much for watching. Do subscribe to our channel Education Express for receiving all the notifications related to the new videos and the new topics that we are going to explore in future. Thank you so much, my guys.